Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How's everybody tonight? Can you lower this just a little? Are you blessed and highly flavored? Yes, you are the salt, right, of the earth. You are the light of the earth. Glory to God. What an honor and a blessing to know who you are, you know? I mean, we've been walking in this world trying to find who we are. What's your identity? And the world tries to give you an identity. Tries to bring you false heroes, temporary things, false successes, temporary things. Everything in the world is temporary. The only thing that can be eternal is through Christ Jesus. Amen? And the identity is being his sons and daughters, which is the most awesome thing that you could have. What an honor. Glory to God. We have entered a new time and season. And in the arena that we have entered, especially for this year, God is going to move quickly. There's going to be a lot of suddenlies. Everyone say suddenly. Suddenly. And if you're not awake, you'll miss it. In fact, if you're not awake, it might overtake you. Ephesians chapter 4, please. Ephesians chapter 4, in verse 11. Thank you, Lord. Is everybody there? Let's speak it together, please. Because what we speak is what we what? Eat. And what we eat is what we become. Amen. And he himself gave some to be what? Apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers for what? For the what? For the what? For the what? For the equipping. How many of y'all know God wants to spiritually equip you? How many of you know if you're not spiritually equipped, you're not going to win too many battles? You'll be easily deceived. You'll easily be put out of position. In fact, you may never even get in position. Hello? Remember, Satan's greatest weapon is deception. And his power is fear. And many people fear things they don't understand. Amen? That's why God gave us the Holy Spirit. So he says, for the equipping of the what? Saints for the work of ministry. For the edifying of the body of Christ. So I want you to understand that there is a spiritually... We are spiritually equipped. Everyone say spiritually equipped. Spiritually equipped. Without being spiritually equipped, you cannot win battles. You'll lose many. That's why the Lord says, my people are destroyed for what? Lack of knowledge. That's spiritual knowledge. You can have all the knowledge of the world and still get your butt kicked. For the equipping of the saints, for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, verse 11, till we all come to the what? Unity of the faith. In the knowledge of the Son of God to a perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Now, there's something very important. Those are three things that he's talking about. He says the unity of the faith. This is why we need to be equipped, right? Spiritually equipped to the unity of the faith. This is what it's going to help us be equipped. Has everybody got it? This is equipping. So that we are become the unity of the faith, the knowledge of the Son of God as a perfect man, that you may know the Son of God as a perfect man. And the fullness of Christ, in other words, the fullness of the anointing. Has everybody got it? I'm going to say it again. The unity of faith. How many of you know you can't do nothing without faith? Faith is what pleases God. Amen. We don't live by sight. We live by faith, right? So to the unity of faith. Unity of faith means connected. That you're connected with the Creator in faith. Because there's times when your faith ends and His faith begins. The second thing is the knowledge of the Son of God to a perfect man. In other words, that you know God, the Son of God, as the perfect man in this realm. He walked perfect. and the fullness of Christ. In other words, the fullness of the anointing, which the anointing is the eternal presence, power, and truth of God Almighty, so that you may know the fullness. That you may know the fullness of the what? The presence of God, the truth of God, and the power of God. Has everybody got it? All right, let's go a little further. Why? Verse 14. That we should no longer be what? Children. Tossed by what? To and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the trickery of men and the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting. But speaking the truth in love may what? Grow up. You cannot grow up without the Holy Spirit. You will stay a child. Hello? Tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by trickery of men and the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting, but speaking the truth in love may grow up in what? All things into him who is the what? Head, Christ, from whom the whole body joined and knit together by what every joint supplies, according to the effective working by which every part does its share, causes growth of the body for the edifying of itself in love. In other words, let me tell you something. You won't even do your part without the Holy Spirit. You'll still be doing your will and not his. You can't do anything without the Holy Spirit. He says, this I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that you should no longer walk as the rest of the Gentiles walk. In other words, he's expressing to you that without the Holy Spirit and the power of the Holy Spirit, you're going to walk just like the regular Gentiles walk. What does he say? Therefore, testify in the Lord that you should no longer walk like the rest of the world in the futility of their mind, being what? Having their what? In other words, they do not have spiritual understanding. True spiritual understanding. Oh, they may understand about going to psychics and mediums and read the stars and the horoscopes. And all. That is not true spiritual power. That is false. It's deceptive. It's new age. It's demonic. And it brings people in bondage. It's amazing how many people I see with a Christian logo on the back of their car and they got a wind catcher hanging on their rearview mirror. Dumb. Because they don't even know what accursed items are. Walking around with logos of marijuana, walking around with logos of bar names of bars where it says food and demons. I mean, food and spirits, but it shouldn't say food and demons. Have no idea the cursed items of movies and books and music that they carry in their homes because they have no spiritual understanding, none. Calling themselves Christians, living outer court, have no power. Tossed to and fro by every wind of doctrine. Anyone says something, they go and believe it. Because they do not know how to test the spirits. They cannot understand. They cannot discern. And without understanding, you and I can do nothing. Understanding is interpretation by the Spirit of the living God. Say that with me. Understanding comes by interpretation of the Holy Spirit. And verse 18, he said, so he's saying, look at man, without the presence and the fullness of Christ, without all of these things, you will not, I want to equip you. You must be spiritually equipped from God Almighty. He said, other than that, without the understanding of the Holy Spirit and the guidance of the Holy Spirit and empower of the Holy Spirit, which is the Spirit of the Father, which has been released to me and you, he says, you're not going to have the understanding. You'll still be, your understanding will be dark and you'll walk like the rest of the world in darkness. What's in darkness? Understanding. Having their understanding darkened, being what? Alienated from the life of God, because you cannot walk in the life of God. Because of the ignorance that is in them, because of the blindness of their heart, verse 19, who being past feeling have given themselves over to what? Lewdness and to work all uncleanness with greediness. He said, but you have not so learned Christ. You've not learned the anointing. You've not maintained. You've not stayed connected. If indeed you have heard from him. Now you got to understand, you've not learned Christ. If indeed you've heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus, that you do what? you put off. What? Concerning your what? Former conduct. You don't have a desire to live the way you used to live. You don't have to think about it. Does everybody get it? You know it. That you put off concerning the former conduct, the old man which grows corrupt according to what? Deceitful lust. So the old man lives according to the deceitful lust. It's deceiving. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind that you put on the what? The new man, which was created according to God in true righteousness and holiness. In other words, be born of the Spirit and reconnected to the Father who created you and me. You know, it's pretty amazing because we lose sight so easy. We get so caught up. The Word talks about us as being sojourners in this realm. We're travelers in this realm. Does everybody get it? We're travelers. We're actually travelers because we're from the future. If you come from eternity, you're from the future. Does everybody get this? And this book expresses the future so that your mind can be reconnected to the future, that you may have your true identity of who you are in the future, from the future, even though you're here in the present. Oh. Grab all of that. Glory. Is everybody okay? Snap it. Let's go to John 14 before I pass out. These are hindrances to people and even so-called believers. Well, I'm a Christian. Well, then why are you still walking in darkness? Why don't you trust? Why don't you surrender? Why don't you live according to the Spirit of God? Because you're not empowered by the Spirit of God. See, there's an area of being filled by the Spirit of God, drinking of the Spirit. That's why you worship. You can't worship. You can't get filled. Does everybody get it? You can't worship. You can't get filled. This is a hint. In other words, there's an arena to... we're to be coming out of the world, even though we're still here in the world. Understanding still in darkness is of the world. Not desiring God's presence is of the world. You know, there's many people who don't even desire God's presence and call themselves Christians. They go to church for duty. They don't go to get in God's presence. Not willing to put away the old for the new one. In other words, the only way to make things new is to cooperate with the new. You're not willing to cooperate, you'll stay right where you're at. John 14. Spiritually equipped. I think this is something that has been well needed, especially at the beginning of this year. Reality must hit. John 14 and verse 15. What does it say? If you love me, keep my commandments. In other words, keep my sayings. And I will pray the Father. Come on, speak it with me. And he will what? Give you another helper. How many of y'all know you need a helper? You can't make it in this realm by yourself, man. That he may what? Abide with you forever. The Spirit of who? The Spirit of who? Truth. The Spirit of who? Come on, read with me. Truth. The Spirit of who? Truth. Spirit of truth. The Spirit of what? Truth. Truth. Whom the world cannot receive. See, the world cannot receive. Amen? The world cannot receive it. Carnally minded cannot receive it. They don't even get it. They mention Jesus. They think religion. Oh, Jesus, yeah. He's the guy that hung on the cross, supposedly. I mean, that's what I heard about. You know, but we live in a New Testament now. I can do anything I want. Well, you're an idiot. And your next step is hell. Hallelujah. And he says, and I prayed the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may abide with you for what? Ever. He's called the Spirit of what?
Truth.
Spirit of what?
Truth.
Truth. Isn't that your first desire in this whole world, is what the heck is the truth? Whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. In other words, he's coming to live in you by the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Amen. He says, I won't leave you orphans. I will what? I will come to you. In a little while longer, and the world will see me no more, but you will see me because I live, and you will live also. At that day you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. On what day? The day you get baptized with the Holy Spirit. Oh, he who has my commandments and keeps them, it is he who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. See, you can't obey without the power of the Holy Spirit. You can't. You can try all you want. He is the Spirit of truth. He is the equipper. The Holy Spirit is the what? Equipper. So that you can become spiritually equipped. He says he will come in you. He will dwell in you on that day. That's the day you get baptized in the Holy Spirit. John 16. Oh, yes. John 16 and verse 5. I'll speak it. But now I go away to him who sent me, and none of you ask me where you are going. But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the what?
Truth.
The truth. It is to your advantage that I go away, for if I do not go away, the what? The helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I will send him to you. That was so powerful. Here's Jesus standing in front of him, then with his disciples and the other ones, around 500 of them or whatever, they're hanging around with him. He says, listen, man, I got to go. What do you mean you got to go? What are we going to do without you? Well, look, don't worry about it. I'm going to come to you, but I'm not going to come in this form. I'm going to come in a form of fire! And I'm going to live in you. I'm going to give you a language where you can speak directly to me and the devil can't interpret it. And it's going to be a language that's going to release so you can pray the perfect will that I want you to. With no interference. And I'll release hidden mysteries to you. I'll establish your thoughts and your steps. I'll cause you to walk in my ways. And I'll give you power to obey my desires. Because your desires will be exchanged for mine. Because you're going to love me. Because I love you. But without connection by the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, you can only fake it. But you can't make it. Oh, glory. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will what? Okay, hold on. Where do I go? Okay, I'm coming back now. Wait a minute. Verse 7, let's speak it. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I'll send him to you. And when he has come, he will what? He's going to convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. Of sin because they do not believe, they don't follow me. Of righteousness because I go to my Father and you see me no more. And of judgment because the ruler of this world is judged. Who's the ruler of this world?
Satan.
He's judged. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. Can you stay awake? Because you cannot bear them. Can you stop from drifting? Does everybody get this? Can you stop? Can you stop and continue to pay attention? That's what the Holy Spirit does. Hey, come on, wake up. Yo! See, people drift easy because they're not filled. When you're filled, you grab hold. You want more. You say, I want more. See, you want to stay. When you get connected, you want to be more connected. You want to be so connected to where it's no longer you no more. You want more of him. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he'll guide you what? Wait a minute, why do you need to go back again? I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them. In other words, you will not be able to understand what I'm telling you until I'm living in you. You will not be able to interpret the words of my Father, the desires of my Father, and the plan of my Father. Everything will just be plain to you. You will read this Bible like a book with no interpretation of true reality. You cannot go any deeper without the Holy Spirit. You'll stay religious, and you'll have a lot of hopes, but no realities. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot understand me yet. However, when he, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of who?
Truth
has come, he's going to do what? He's going to guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. In other words, what is he saying? He said, when the Father is releasing to you through the Word of God, through dreams or visions, only the Holy Spirit is one who's going to interpret it. Only he can interpret for you. Without the interpretation of the Holy Spirit, you do a lot of guessing and a lot of assumption and a lot of drifting. And because he says, and I'll tell you things, I'll guide you to all truth and tell you things to come. Only the Holy Spirit does the interpreting. Why? Because he's the one who's the equipper. And he said, he will glorify me. He will give glory and honor to the name of Jesus because Jesus paid the price. But the body of Jesus is the body of the Holy Spirit. Has everybody got it? The body of Jesus is the body of the Holy Spirit in this realm. Because he's the Spirit of the Father who came into this realm, but labeled him Jesus and called him Son. Who impregnated Mary? The Holy Spirit. Amen. That's so God, the Spirit, could come into this realm from the future, eternity. He said, he'll glorify me, for he will take of what is mine and do what? Declare it to you. So the only way to interpret, the only way to get the things from the Father is through who? The Holy Spirit. All things that the Father has are mine. Therefore, I said, he will take of mine and declare it to you. The Holy Spirit is the one who equips each follower that is willing or has a desire to be equipped. Amen? You must have a desire to be equipped. God will never force you to do anything. One of the things the Holy Spirit begins to do in your life is he begins to filter out the carnal, old nature, the natural man. He begins to filter out and interprets the eternal words, events, and commands and desires of God. Why? Because you begin to get understanding. Understanding is nothing but the interpretation of the Holy Spirit for me and you. That's why the word says, get understanding. Get understanding. Well, I don't understand. Well, get it. You're only going to get it through the Holy Spirit. First, you got a desire to be baptized and filled with the Holy Spirit, or you're not going to get it anyways. You can try and figure it out. You can look at every commentary, every Strong's dictionary. You can look up everything and still not get the full understanding of it, because you're not going to look it up and find what the true meaning of believe means. Whether it's Greek, Latin, Egyptian, Hungarian, I don't care what it is. You're not going to try to, only through the Holy Spirit will you find, will find a true interpretation of believe. It means to follow. The Holy Spirit's got his own dictionary. Hallelujah. Ezekiel 36. Ezekiel 36. Don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with looking into the Strong's and whatever, do some cross interpretations, but I'm telling you the true interpretation of everything of God in this word comes by the Holy Spirit. Ezekiel 36, 25. Let's start somewhere else. Let's start at 23. What does it say? And I will sanctify my great name, which has been profaned among the nations, which you have profaned in their midst. In other words, B.C. We profaned his name before Christ. Which you have profaned in their midst, and the nation shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord. When I am what? Hallowed, honored, respected, and feared. Hallowed, honored, respected, and feared. Does everybody get it? Where? And you before their eyes. When they see that you reverence and honor God Almighty, when they see that you're on fire, you have a zealous for God, that you love Him, it can only be done by the Spirit of God. He said, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to use you as a sign and wonder because you and I are going to reconnect just like we were before. I'm going to be a father and you'll be my sons and daughters. Verse 24, and I'll take you from among the nations, gather you out of all countries, and bring you into your own land, a place of present. Then I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you shall be clean. In other words, I'm going to wash you with my blood. And I will cleanse you from all your what? Filthiness, worldliness, and from all your worldly idols. Does everybody see that? How many of you know that you can be the idol? Amen. And I will give you a what? A new heart and a new spirit within you. And I'll take the heart of stone, which means rebellious heart, out of your flesh. And I'll give you a heart of flesh, which is moldable, flexible. And then what? Verse 27. And I will put my spirit. Who is my spirit? The Holy Spirit. Within you and cause you to walk in my statutes. And you will keep my judgments in what? And you will do them. He's going to cleanse us from all of our worldly idols and stuff. And he's going to, that have separated us from his will and fellowship. And he's going to give us a new heart, a new spirit. And his spirit that he's going to give us will interpret all of God's will and desires for us with power to overcome evil resistance. So you already got it. To overcome what? Evil resistance. Is doubt evil resistance? Is unbelief evil resistance? Is rebellion evil resistance? Is lust evil resistance? Does everybody understand? Is pride evil resistance? Yes. Good. Titus 3. Listen, I talk about the Holy Spirit and I get drunk. I love talking about him, man. He is so cool. I mean, you know, he's the best, man. That's why Jesus left the best for us. You get it? He left the best. Why want the good when you can wait for the best? People just are content with good, man. God said, I want you the best. I come to bring you life and life abundantly. I want my children to have the best. I want them to be signs and wonders to the world. I want them to prosper. I want them to walk in the power of the Holy Spirit. I want them to know me. I want them to see me in them. Glory. And I didn't have no coffee. Where'd I say go, Titus? Titus, is everybody there? Okay. Titus 3, even. Verse 4. Somewhere around there. Verse 4, Titus. Tighten up and go to verse 4. Let's begin. But when the kindness of the love of God our Savior toward man appeared, not by works of righteousness, which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us through the washing of what? Regeneration and the renewing of the what? Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us abundantly through Jesus Christ our Savior, that having been justified by his grace, we should become heirs according to the hope of what? Eternal life. Whoa, this is a faithful saying. And these things I want you to affirm when? When you feel like it? Constantly. Constantly affirm this. What? I am regenerated by the Holy Spirit, reconnected to eternal. I am a time traveler from the future. I am established. I am perfected in him, not in me. I am more than a conqueror. I am blessed with every spiritual blessing, seated in heavenly places. And if God be for me, who can be against me? I am because he is. This is a faithful saying, and these things I want you to affirm constantly, that those who have believed in God should be careful to maintain good works. These things are good and profitable to what? To man. But of course, he says, but avoid foolish disputes, genealogies, contentions, and strivings about the law, for they are unprofitable and useless. And they will cause you separation. In other words, do not grieve the Holy Spirit. We are regenerated, renewing of the Holy Spirit, equipped, the equipper. He's the equipper, the empowerer, and the interpreter. I'm going to say it again. He's the equipper, the empowerer, and the interpreter. Isaiah 55. Isaiah 55. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. You can be so close to the Spirit of God that you can give him another name. I used to call the Holy Spirit Buddy because he was my buddy. Just come out of darkness, out of the pits of hell, addicted, sick, and then baptized and filled with the Holy Spirit and visitation from the Lord, totally healed. First thing the Lord introduced me to after he said his word was true was the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, this is my son Guy. Hey, buddy, what's going on? And me and Buddy been tight ever since. Man, I got some stories about Buddy, let me tell you. Verse 1. Is everybody there? Good. Isaiah 55, verse 1. Ho, everyone who what? Who thirsts, come to the what? Waters. And you have no money, come and what? Buy and eat. Well, you gotta, how are you going to buy with no money? You got to cooperate. That's the price. Yes, come and buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend money for what is not bread and your wages for what does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, says the Lord, and eat what is good, and let your soul delight itself in abundance. Incline your ear and come to me. Hear, and your soul shall live. I will make an everlasting covenant with you, the sure mercies of David. Indeed, I've given him as a witness to the people, a leader and commander for the people. Surely you shall call a nation you do not even know, and nations who do not know you shall run to you because of the Lord your God and the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. And let the wicked forsake his way and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord and he will have mercy on him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Are you ready for the next one? He says, my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than yours, and my thoughts are higher than yours. For as the rain comes down and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth, and make it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my what? My word or my voice be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. Now, how is that going to be done? How are you going to know the thoughts of God? The Holy Spirit. Yeah. How are you going to know his ways? How are you going to know his desires? Holy Spirit. He is the spiritual equipper. He is the equipper, the empowerer, and the interpreter. Has everybody got it? Oh, great. Ephesians 1. Glory. Ephesians chapter 1. Ephesians 1, 3. Is everybody there? Let's speak it. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us, or that word blessed also here means equipped. It means what? Equipped. When you are blessed, you're equipped. Who's equipped us with... Now, are you going to find that in the dictionary? No. But you'll find it in Buddy's dictionary. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has equipped us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ, in the anointing. Just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world. He chose us before the foundation of the world, before the universe was created. We have a hard time comprehending that because of our little peanut brain. He chose us before the world was created, the universe was created, that we should be what? That we should be what? Holy. That's why he's called Holy Spirit. Not carnal spirit. Holy Spirit will bring holiness. Holiness means you are right standing with God. It doesn't matter how you dress, although it'll have some kind of effect to it, you know what I'm saying? You know. Hallelujah. Anyways, we won't go there. That we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having what? Predestined us to adoption as sons by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, by which he made us accepted in the beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin according to the riches of his grace, which he made to abound toward us in all what? Wisdom and prudence. Having made known to us the what? How are we going to get the mystery of his will? To the interpretation of the Holy Spirit. According to his good pleasure, which he purposed to himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of times, he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth in him. In him also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of him who works all things according to the counsel of his will, that we who first trusted in Christ should be to the praises of his glory. We are blessed. We are equipped with every spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus. In other words, in Christ, Christ means in the anointing, the eternal presence, power, and truth of God Almighty. Amen. Romans 7. Oh, hallelujah. Romans 7, 4. Let's speak it. Therefore, my brethren, you also have become dead to the law through the body of Christ, that you may be married to another. To who? To him. Does everybody get it? To him who was raised from the dead, that we should bear fruit to God. For when we were in the flesh, BC, the sinful passions which were aroused by the law were at work in our members to bear fruit to what? Death. But now we have been delivered from the law, having died to what we have held by, so that we should serve the what? Serve in the newness of the Spirit and not in the oldness of the letter, so that we should serve in the newness of the Spirit. Serving in other words, walking away from old, living in the Spirit. Serving in the newness of the Spirit, in other words, serving being equipped by the Holy Spirit, 2 Corinthians 3. In verse 1. Let's speak it. Do we begin again to commend ourselves, or do we need, as some others, what? Epistles of commendation to you, or letters of commendations from you? You are what? Our epistle written in our hearts, known and read by all men. Clearly you are an epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but by what? By the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of flesh, that is, the heart. And we have such trust through Christ toward God, not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think of anything as being from ourselves, but our sufficiency is from God, who has made us sufficient as ministers of the new covenant, not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter kills, but the Spirit does what? Gives life. So we are of the ministry of the Spirit now. Amen? Isaiah 61. Everyone say, I'm spiritually equipped, being connected to the throne room of God by the Holy Spirit. I am a time traveler. Oh, snap. <I see. laughs> Isaiah 61. Is everybody there? Let's confess this together. Everyone say it. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has what? Anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to console those who mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they may be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. See, I mean, that's powerful. That's your confession. This is why God called us out of the pit of darkness, out of the darkness of in understanding, to where we walk in the light of understanding and the truth and be anointed only through the Holy Spirit. No man come to the Father unless the Spirit draws you. But the Spirit draws you, but he's waiting for you to surrender to possess you. 1 Corinthians 12. Every victory is won. Every battle is won by a fight. That's why it's called a battle. Which you are fighting for in a constant arena. Because the resistance of the enemy wants to nullify the anointing in your life. He wants to cause you to disconnect, drift, or become more dependent on yourself and what the world says instead of the promises and covenant of God. You fight for healing. Does everybody understand that? You must fight for healing. That is the price. Well, there's no victory without a price. You fight to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. You don't give up. You believe. You say, I don't care what anybody says. This is what the Word says. This is what I'm standing on. Amen. You fight for it. No matter what's going on, you fight. Does everybody get it? It doesn't mean you don't see a doctor. Go see a doctor. But while you're seeing a doctor, still fight for your healing. Amen? Believe me, if I got a headache, I'm fighting for it. I'm going to still pop some Advil while I'm fighting for it. Amen? Since it's in my cupboard. Okay. 1 Corinthians 12. Verse 1. Is everybody there? Now concerning spiritual gifts. Now wait a minute. Spiritual gifts. The word gifts means tools. Amen? How many of y'all, God wants to equip you with tools? And you're not going to go out and change a flat tire with a basketball. Or a football. You're going to have a jack and a wrench and all kinds of things. Now concerning spiritual tools or spiritual gifts. Brethren, I don't want you to be idiots. I mean ignorant. I want you to have the correct interpretation. You don't, let me get, this is a big conflict in the body. Because there are many who don't believe in this. They believe that all the gifts are no good because they don't have the Holy Spirit. They try to tell you can't speak in tongues when they haven't even been baptized in tongues themselves. Oh, I don't believe in any of that. That's of the devil. That's gone then. Who told you that? It's amazing. It's baffling to me. After my visitation from the Lord, I mean, I wanted to go rescue people all over the place. But I was shut down by pastors and churches that did not believe in what happened to me or believed that I was speaking in tongues. You just got saved. What the heck's that got to do with anything? There was the first question those religious spirits would ask me. How long you been saved? 48 hours. And you're going to tell me about the things of God? No, but he is. I would leave places and I'd say, Daddy, I don't understand. He says, don't worry, they don't understand me. It's a shame. We're to want everything God came in the flesh, hung on a cross, every drop of blood that he dripped for me and you. He wants to give us everything. I mean, I just think it's shameful to not want everything that God has for us. He paid such a price being whipped, being persecuted, being lied about, being betrayed, hung on the cross in front of all men, and died for me and you. He paid the price for me and you to have everything. Far be it that we shouldn't desire everything. Amen. That's his desire. Amen?
Okay.
Verse 2. You know that you were Gentiles, carried away with these dumb idols, religious people, however you were led. Therefore, I make known to you that no one speaking by the Spirit of God calls Jesus accursed, and no one can say that Jesus is Lord except for by the Holy Spirit. There are diversities of tools. Everybody understand that these gifts of the Spirit are tools. Amen? But the same what? Spirit. And what Spirit is that? The Holy Spirit. And there are differences of ministries, but the same Lord. And what Lord is that? He's still called the Spirit, isn't he? Amen. And there are diversities of activities, but it is the same God. He's the Spirit of God who works all in all. Now, I want you to understand that it's also the Trinity being revealed. It is the Trinity of the God, the Spirit, God, the Son, and God, the Father here. Okay? Verse 7. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to each one for what? The profit of all. So God wants to manifest himself through me and you through the tools or the gifts of the Spirit. For one is given the word of wisdom through the Spirit. Does everybody understand it? It doesn't mean that one person has the word of wisdom. If you're baptized with the Holy Spirit, every tool is available. So quit waiting. And look, let me tell you something. Stop trying to calculate which one it is. Just do it. Hello? If somebody's sick, lay hands on them. Cast out the devil. If you sense something coming by the Spirit of God and you see something, speak it. It's called word of knowledge. Word of understanding. Word of wisdom. Whatever it is, it's by the Spirit. Don't worry about what the label is of it. Paul labeled it so that you would understand that all of these are available for you. It didn't mean that one person. I remember one time somebody came up to me and said, I can interpret tongues, but I can't pray in it. I said, you're an idiot. I didn't call him an idiot right out there. I thought that. He was a pastor, so I wasn't going to call him an idiot. But I thought, what's the matter? How can you interpret tongues and not be baptized in the Holy Spirit? You can't! Hello? I can interpret tongues, or really? Bukarabashiki. Let me see you interpret that one. He would interpret it, and probably the Holy Spirit was saying, you're an idiot. You know? Oh, hallelujah. Does everybody understand this? It says one was given, but the manifestation goes through all the gifts. For one is given the word of wisdom through the Spirit, another the word of knowledge through the same, another faith by the same Spirit, another gifts of healings by the same Spirit, and to another the workings of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning the spirits, to another different kinds of tongues. Your tongue will change. The Holy Spirit can cause you to pray in any language you want, not that you want, that He wants. Amen. You'll pray in an unknown language and you'll be on a plane. And next thing, the Holy Spirit will say, pray in the Spirit. You'll be bukarashi kirabokosa. Next thing, boom, your language changes. It's like, whoa. I've heard come out of my language Chinese, Japanese, Indian, all kinds of stuff, man. One day I got slam dunked in the Holy Spirit in my living room. I think I spoke every language of every country and every language that I was rolling in my living room. To another working in different kinds, and to another interpretation of what? Tongues. Interpretation of tongues. Interpretation of God's words also. Amen? But one in the same Spirit. One in the same Spirit. One in the, it's the same equipper. Works all these things, distributing to each one individual as he wills or as needed. Does everybody get it? Is everybody okay? We are spiritually equipped with the Holy Spirit and equipped with spiritual tools. Oh, I want to go a little further on this one. All right. Verse 12. For as the body is one and has many members, but all members of that one body being many are one body, so also is Christ. Are you ready? For by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, whether slaves or Jews, and have all been made to what? Drink. In what? In how do you drink? Worship. See, people don't drink. You got to get drunk. You get drunk by drinking. And you get drinking and get drunk by worship. If you don't worship, you don't get drink. You don't get drink, you don't get drunk. That's it. Everybody cool? Luke 3. I'm glad you're driving, honey. Man, I could go on for days. I think we might have to have a part two. Okay. Verse 15. Did I say Luke 3? Verse 15. Oh, cool. Now, as the people were what? In expectation and all reason in their hearts about John the Baptist, whether he was the Christ or not, John answered, saying, all, I indeed baptize you with water, but one mightier than I is coming, whose sandal strap I am not worthy to loose. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. His winnowing, whatever, fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly clean out his threshing floor, gathering the wheat into his barn. Wheat meaning saved righteous ones. But the chaff, the rebellious ones, he will burn with unquenchable fire. And with many other exhortations, he preached to the people. John the Baptist baptized with water. He was an example of the forerunner of Christ, of the washing of sin. Jesus would baptize us first with washing us with the blood of Christ and then filling us with the Holy Spirit and fire of power, spiritually equipping his followers with the anointing of the presence, power, and truth. Amen? I'm going to close at Acts 1 because I got a lot more. Is everybody okay? Did you get this? Just call on Buddy. No. He is the Holy Spirit. Jesus. You know, it's a promise. You understand? But you got to stay connected, man. You got to stay drunk, drinking. You got to worship. Look at you. Just don't throw some words out there and then sit down. Don't come and do your duty. Come and change. Amen? Don't just do your duty. Fight. If you have to shed enough flesh to get into that presence, do it. Worship. Listen, people do all kinds of stuff out there. When we were out there seeking to get high, seeking to chase the opposite, man, we went through great lengths. We waited. We hunted. We searched out. We burned the phones out, man. We waited all night long. You fought to get the dope. And then we got stupid when we got it. We fought to fulfill our flesh. Now fight to fulfill your spirit. Amen? Acts 1:4. Let's speak it. And being assembled together with them, Jesus did what? He did what? He did what? He did what?
Commanded.
He commanded. Can you imagine? He commanded us. He commanded us. He said, look, don't you go nowhere without being baptized in the Holy Spirit, because you cannot be my witness. You will fail without being baptized in the Holy Spirit. He, being assembled with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard from me. For John truly did what? Baptize with water. But you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Well, they still really didn't get it. They began to say, well, therefore, when they had come together, they asked Jesus, saying, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom of Israel? Jesus was not talking about the kingdom of Israel. He's talking about the kingdom of God, because those guys still didn't get understanding. He was with them, but the Spirit was not in them yet. And Jesus turned around and said to them, it's not for you to know the times and seasons which the Father has put in his own authority. But you shall receive what? You shall receive what?
Power.
Power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and to the end of the earth. You know, power. You know, if you don't put an engine in a car, you're going to push it. Amen? The engine is the power of the car. Right? When the engine breaks down, it becomes two-legged power. Amen? You cannot outrun a horse. A horse will outrun you. So you need horsepower. How? You get on the horse. Amen? It's the same thing with the Spirit. You don't have no power. You just be a shell. But when the Spirit comes in you and empowers you, you have power to say yes to him and no to him. You have power to see things through. You have power to interpret. You have power to complete what God has caused you to start. Amen? But you got to stay connected. You got to stay filled. You got to stay dressed. You got to stay possessed. And you got to stay drunk, because then you don't care. Amen? About the things of the world. Because the world will bring entanglements in upon you. The world will contaminate you. But only the King of Glory can make a way for you. And he has. He paid a tremendous price for me and you to have it all. You can actually have your cake and eat it too. With anointed frosting on it. Amen? Praise God. Father, we thank you for your word. We are honored and blessed. Have mercy upon us and let your grace abound. Now, buddy, we really need your help. So I'm asking that you'll visit everyone and heal everyone. In the mighty name of Jesus, express yourself, manifest yourself, show them who you really are. Every listener, everyone listening to this teaching, and everyone watching, Lord, touch, change, heal, deliver, and free them from themselves, that they may be empowered and reconnected to you as sons and daughters with the true identity that they had before they came, that they may bring glory to your name in Jesus' name. And everybody said amen.